Sometimes it's useful to discover the hierarchical structure of a set of data, such as the parse trees of a group of sentences. In these cases, recursive neural tensor networks, or RNTNs, are a better fit than feed-forward or recurrent nets. Let's take a closer look and see why. RNTNs were conceived by Richard Socher of MetaMind as part of his PhD thesis at Stanford. The purpose of these nets was to analyze data that had a hierarchical structure. Originally, they were designed for sentiment analysis, where the sentiment of a sentence depends not just on its component words, but on the order in which they're syntactically grouped. So let's take a look at the structure of an RNTN. An RNTN has three basic components: a parent group, which we'll call the root, and the child groups, which we'll call the leaves. Each group is simply a collection of neurons, where the number of neurons depends on the complexity of the input data. As you can see, the root is connected to both leaves, but the leaves are not connected to each other. Technically speaking, the three components form what's called a binary tree. In general, the leaf groups receive input, and the root group uses a classifier to fire out a class and a score. We'll get to the significance of these two values in a moment. An RNTN structure may seem simple, but just like a recurrent net, the complexity comes from the way in which data moves throughout the network. In the case of an RNTN, this process is recursive. To see how this recursion works, let's take a look at an example. Let's feed an English sentence into the net and receive the sentence's parse tree as output. At step 1, we feed the first two words into leaf groups 1 and 2, respectively. As a practical note, the leaf groups do not actually receive the words per se, but rather vector representations of the words. A vector is just an ordered set of numbers, and it's been shown that these nets work best with very specific vector representations. Particularly, good results are achieved when the numbers in the two vectors encode the similarities between the two words when compared to other words in the vocabulary. The exact details of this process are beyond the scope of this video. The two vectors move across the net to the root, which processes them and fires out two values, the class and the score. The score represents the quality of the current parse, and the class represents an encoding of a structure in the current parse. This is the point where the net starts the recursion. At the next step, the first leaf group now receives the current parse, rather than a single word. The second leaf group receives the next word in the sentence. At this point, the root group would output the score of a parse that is three words long. This continues until all the inputs are used up, and the net has a parse tree with every single word included. This simplified example illustrates the main idea behind an RNTN, but in a practical application, we typically encounter more complex recursive processes. Rather than use the next word in the sentence for the second leaf group, an RNTN would try all of the next words and, eventually, vectors that represent entire sub-parses. By doing this at every step of the recursive process, the net is able to analyze and score every possible syntactic parse. Have you ever had to work with data where the underlying patterns were hierarchical? Please comment and let us know what you learned. Shown here are the three possible parse trees for the same sentence. To pick the best one, the net relies on the score value produced by the root group. By using this score to select the best substructure at each step of the recursive process, the net will produce the highest scoring parse as its final output. Once the net has the final structure, it backtracks through the parse tree in order to figure out the right grammatical label for each part of the sentence. Here, it does that one first and labels it as a noun phrase. Then it works on this, and you get a verb phrase. It then works its way up, and when it reaches the top, it adds a special label that signifies the beginning of the parse structure. RNTNs are trained with backpropagation by comparing the predicted sentence structure with the proper sentence structure obtained from a set of labeled training data. Once trained, the net will give a higher score to structures that are more similar to the parse trees that it saw in training. RNTNs are used in natural language processing for both syntactic parsing and sentiment analysis. They are also used to parse images, typically when an image contains a scene with many different components. In the next video, we'll take a closer look at the many applications of deep learning.